Hey guys, it's Sarah Young with Mindless Matters, and today I'm going to talk about how to have a more chemical-free home, less toxins in our home, using essential oils. Now, this is a topic that you may not think about when it comes to essential oils. You might think of skincare or remedies or things like that, but I use them just as powerfully in my home to create less toxins and with my cleaning products and candles and things like that, air fresheners, sprays, things like that. So we're going to go over that today. So if you're looking to eliminate some of the toxins in your home for your children, for yourself, and you're looking for options that are affordable and safe, then this is for you. So I'm going to go over some real world examples of how I actually use them in my day-to-day life and even show you some ways that I actually go about it, okay? So let's jump into it. Now, first off, I just want to thank you so much for being here. So hello, my name is Sarah Young. I'm the creator of Mindless Matters, which is a natural living and motherhood and lifestyle blog. And I'm obsessed with all things natural for my family and for myself. And so essential oils are a great component of that I've run across over the last couple years. And I've been using them for about 2 years now. And so the thing with our homes is we want to create these beautiful, peaceful, clean environments. And we don't realize sometimes that some of the stuff that we're putting in can actually be doing more harm than good. And so a lot of the stuff in the stores that is marketed to us actually has a lot of toxins and fragrances and things in that are actually wreaking havoc on our peaceful, beautiful homes. And some of those could be fragrances, synthetic fragrances that are lab manufactured, pretty much a lot of products out there, from baby products to skincare products to cleaning products. They all have a lot of these synthetics in them, and they actually can go on our skin and create, we're seeing a huge epidemic of eczema and skin conditions and psoriasis and all this stuff, especially even on babies, which is crazy. And really, I believe that it's linking back to a lot of the toxins that are in our home. So if we can start eliminating those things and using less of those cleaning products and stuff, then I really think that I've seen for myself that we can really impact our family's life from the start, whether they're little babies or whether they're older, and ourselves, and eliminate these toxins out, okay? So some things, ways that you actually can do it is through something like, first off, let's talk about candles. I've talked about candles in my previous videos where candles have a lot of synthetics. They're expensive. Sure, they create great ambiances. My previous life, I was an interior designer before I was a mom, and kind of on sabbatical from that right now. And so I love ambiance, okay? If anybody, I do. But they have so much junk in them that actually can go in and wreak havoc on our bodies. So instead, having something as simple as a diffuser in your home instead of a candle, and you can have instead battery-operated candles, which I have that come on as on automatic timers in all rooms of my house to create that beautiful ambiance. But then I have diffusers that are doing the smell. And so something like an oil like purification. Purification is a perfect oil for getting rid of the smells in our home. So if you have kids or if you have pets, you know how it is, maybe even a sticky husband, you can diffuse an oil like purification in the air. You could even combine it with some lemon and have that going. We'll do this a lot if there's like some smelly, nasty junk in our home, which seems to happen on a reoccurring basis with two boys. So we'll have that going and actually can get rid of those smells. So same with purification now when it comes to actual like bug sprays and stuff. We may think of that as more of like a beauty type thing, but that's putting out toxins and smells when we're breathing it in and applying it to our body. So instead, an oil like purification or citronella or lemongrass, those are great oils to help repel bugs. And so even for bug bites, those are great ones to apply on with purification oil. I use purification oil also to put in my husband's boots. So he's in the military, he works some crazy hours on aircraft, and so sometimes his shoes come home smelling, which everybody has smelly shoes at some point, right? But his aren't always the best. And so I'll have him drop a couple drops of the purification oil to help with the smell. If you have a pet, you can actually take the purification oil or something similar and take a spray bottle, fill it with water, put a couple drops of the oil in, shake it, and use it to spray the beds of your pets to help them smell better, okay? So that is an option for smelly stuff. You can use it to clean your refrigerator with instead of bleaches and things like that. So that's an option. For me, I actually will also use oils for making my own soaps. So I'll take really pretty bottles and I'll get a bunch of Dr. Bronner's Castile soap from the internet, from Amazon. I'll get a big jug of this. This will last me like 8 months. And I'll make a ton of stuff with it, from my own washing detergents to my own hand soaps. I'll even make foaming hand soaps with it so that it foams instead of it being a liquid. This is like a foaming hand soap thing. And I'll mix it in with the corresponding oil that I want. So it could be something like lavender that I put in, or I love the smell of lavender and lemon. And so these two could be put in. If you're looking for something more like a hand sanitizer thing, you could use an oil like Thieves and put it into the hand soap. If you're looking for your own hand sanitizer, I take a spray bottle, I fill it with water, put a little witch hazel in it, and then I drop in the oil I'm looking for, which for hand sanitizers, I would use Thieves oil. I would also maybe put in some lavender to cut the smell of the Thieves. The Thieves oil kind of smells a little Christmassy, so I like to put some lavender in to kind of give it more of a subtle smell. And then I'll use it to spray my son's toys. We've used it on airplanes where we've sprayed spray tables with it, the windows, and we wipe it all down. So those are great things. Spray his hands off with it. It's like this multi-use thing I can keep in my purse. Tables when we're about to eat. Or like I said, I'll take and make a bigger one and use it to spray his toys. So if we have kids up over that are playing with the toys and they tend to put stuff in their mouths and stuff like that, right? I'll take this and I'll spray it down, and then I don't have to like worry about like him getting bleach in his mouth or something later. It's just be a very simple and easy way for me to clean up his room and all the germs that might have ended up on some of his toys if he takes them to the park or whatever. To wash our clothes. Dryer sheets are one of the most toxic things we could possibly use. We don't want to use them. They're expensive for one, but also they have so many chemicals on them. So what was suggested now, and what I use, is I use dryer balls. And these are wool dryer balls, and you can get them for, I don't know, like 10 bucks or something on Amazon. They'll last like up to like 2 years. And you, when they get too dirty, you just wash them and then you dry and leave them out to dry. But basically you take them and they'll get the static and everything out of your clothes. And also they can make your clothes smell good by using the oil you want. So you could take lavender oil and put a couple drops on and pop it in the dryer. You could take an oil for something really smelly, like some sporting gear, like purification, and pop it in the dryer. You could take even something else like, frankincense. If you like want some clothes to really smell like a grounded smell, like your yoga clothes or something, and pop it in the dryer. So that's a way to get rid of that. It's so much more affordable too, and it doesn't have the toxins, okay? Dryer balls. Cleaning our counters. I don't use household cleaner anymore or from the store. I make my own. What I do is I get a bottle like this. I fill the majority of it with water, and then I can pop in a couple of the oils. Like Thieves oil is known to kill, like I read somewhere in some statistic that it kills like, that blend kills like 99% of like junk. And so I'll use it for just like a hand sanitizer. I'll use it to clean my counters with. And they actually now make something called Thieves Cleaner Concentrate, which is basically a concentrated version of the Thieves oil that you can take to make your own cleaning products with. So I'll take, all you need is like a capful of it. And so I'll just take a capful of the concentrated Thieves Cleaner, and which is originated from the oil. And then I'll put that capful in a bottle like this. And it lasts me like, seriously, like something like this would last me like months and months and months. And so I then have something that doesn't have the junk, the toxins, when I'm spraying. My son can now help me clean the house without me worrying that he's going to get something that's going to hurt his eye or something. Well, sure, Thieves oil, we want to be careful about not spraying in our face, but it's not going to be bleach or something, right? It doesn't have these chemicals in it. So that's an option. Actually take the same type of thing and make scrubs. So I'll take and put some baking soda, and I'll take some of the either the Thieves oil and lemon, or I'll take some of the Thieves concentrate, which is originated from that oil, and I'll put a little capful in, and I'll mix it with some baking soda, and then I use it to scrub things. And it even kind of acts like a Mr. Clean Eraser to scrub counters and, or to scrub walls and clean showers and things like that. So isn't that cool? I also will take, lemon oil. Lemon oil is perfect by itself to use to get gum out of things or sticky or goo stuff. I actually tested it against like a Gooby on, and it worked just as good. And it didn't have the nasty, crazy smell that you would associate with it. It actually smelled good. So that's great for sticky net messes. If you get stickers on something, your kids put stickers everywhere, you can use lemon to get those stickers off. You can use the same type of thing to clean windows. So I use that. I take this type of option with the thieves and some of the water, and I use a different ratio, a little less or a little more, depending what I'm doing. If I'm doing a degreaser or a window cleaner or something, and I actually use just water and the oils to make those products. And it's so affordable and it's easy because I can just like make it up. I never run out anymore. Let's see some other things that I'll use. Spraying like our linen sprays instead of like, or potpourri. So instead of having a smelly, like in the bathroom, when someone goes to the bathroom and they leave a nasty smell, you might have a diffuser going, or you could actually leave something like this in it and call it potpourri spray, and have some lavender and some lemon or some purification or some type of oils that you like the smell of, and mix up your own smelly spray. And instead, it's your own air freshener. And so it doesn't have all of the nasty stuff that's in air fresheners. Instead, it dispels it gets rid of the smell. It also smells great. And your kids can use it without you worrying about them like spraying some toxin in their face. So after my son goes into the bathroom, or potty training and stuff right now, I'll have him spray this after it, and it works. You can also make your own like bathroom nasty spray to spray off the toilet seats. So if you have boys, you can actually make a great cleaner with just water and some thieves oil and some lemon, and take it in a spray bottle or add some purification into it, and they can use it to spray off the seat after they use the bathroom. So if they're getting messes on the floor, things, you can give them something to get in the routine that's also safe for them to use to clean up after themselves. So these are things that you can start using to eliminate the things in your home, but then you can use those same oils for beauty remedies, for emotional things, for sleep things, for focus things. So you see how you can use that same bottle for so many different options. So it's really, really cool. And then also you're eliminating the toxins in your home that can screw up your endocrine system, screw up your hormones, screw up your skin, screw up the different things in your life that we're breathing in so much. I read somewhere that the average mom and family is exposed to over 200 chemicals before they leave the house in the morning. That's, you know, between us doing all the different things, 200 before we even leave our home. So if we can make an effort to get rid of some of those toxins in our home environment, and have a chemical-free home, then, we're one step closer. You know, we can't eliminate all the things outside in our environment, but we can do something inside our homes. And so if we can eliminate those 200 before we even leave the house, sure, we're really making a step forward in our health for ourselves and for our kids, okay? And so, you know, it could then go into things like our health. So like nasal sprays, instead of, you could make your own nasal sprays with like frankincense and lavender and some sea salt and a little nasal spray pump. You can make your own face washes. So you could take a pump and make your own face washes. You can find these recipes on my blog and put in something that correlates to your skin needs, whether it's dry, whether it's sensitive, whether it's oily. So these are things that you can start eliminating beyond cleaning, but eliminating that with using the same ingredients to eliminate more and more toxins, okay? So I hope you enjoyed this training today. I'm like looking around at all my stuff to see if there's anything else that I could share with you, but I think we covered a lot of ground, and you can check my blog for recipes, but also I would love to invite you, if you wanna learn more about oils, to a webinar I'm having that's gonna dive more into how to use oils for our families, for our kids, for ourselves, and give you some more information. So I would love for you to join in on that. Click the link and you'll be able to be sent over to that so that you can watch that webinar and get some more further training and information to see if oils are right fit for your life. And I'll provide you some information and extra stuff in there to really help further your journey in using the oils. So thanks so much for being here. Be sure to click that link. I'll see you over on the webinar.